Recently, I went out to see It Chapter 2, and being a huge, huge fan of the original miniseries It, some of the book, because sadly I have not read all of it, and then also the It Chapter 1, I figured I'd go see it with some friends, and yeah, let's talk about it. So It Chapter 2 is obviously the second chapter continuing from the first movie that released a few years ago following the Losers Club, and who are now all adults. And they have come back to Derry because they made a promise that if this thing ever returned, that they would come back. And as adults, they've all kind of sort of forgot what happened as they've left and moved on. And except one, Mike, who stayed in town, and he remembers all of it. So when people start missing and bodies start turning up and whatnot, he calls them all back to remind them of what they promised and bring them back and hopefully bring an end to it. So this was a long time coming. I was super excited for this movie. I have watched the original probably 3 or 4 times, which is quite a bit for me these days on rewatching movies. So I, you know, really pumped. I went with a group of friends. We got out. Honestly, we loved it. We all really enjoyed that movie. And for me, you know, it comes from a few factors on why I liked it. So first off, the time, the runtime. The runtime on this movie is like 2 hours and I think 45 minutes or 55 minutes. Maybe it's 55 minutes. Close to 3 hours. To me, it didn't feel like it at all. I was totally enthralled in this flick. It never was slow to me. I was just in it. I was in the zone. And there was even a point where I was like midway through, I think, and I was like, I have to use the restroom. I'm going to hold it. And I held it. Because I was so into the movie, I just was like, nope, bladder be damned. I'm staying in my seat and watching this whole flick. So that was one aspect. And it's only like 15 minutes longer than the original. The original was actually pretty long too, overall. So there was that going for it. The other aspect of the movie, which I can understand some people not maybe caring for as much or maybe feeling a difference in, is kind of the overall tone and feeling theme of the movie. Because, you know, the first movie did have this kind of cool nostalgia filled feeling of being with a group of kids like you might have when you're younger, the memories, and going against something that's terrifying. And it kind of had that, I don't know, I don't want to say whimsical, but it just had this feeling, this kid feeling of like, you know, like these horrible things are happening, but it's, the world's not that horrible because, you know, kids and imagination and just their perseverance to just, you know, be kids and whatnot. And that's not to say It 1 wasn't dark. It definitely was. But It 2, they're adults now, and I feel like the themes in this just go completely darker. And It 1, we had themes of abuse and other hardcore things. And here we have things hardcore focusing on sexuality, violence, abusive natures, you know, suicide. These are things that are really dark things that, you know, could potentially, you know, make people really upset watching the movie. And I understand that because, you know, watching it myself, I'm just thinking, you know, especially early on in the movie, just like, man, this is pretty dark. It's not really good, you know, not really good feelings, good vibes. But I got it. Like, the tone on this one is they're adults. We're in an adult world. And yeah, it's something in that regard. Now, for me personally, I also feel that the comedy in this was great. I laughed a lot. And this also came from the two characters, Richie and Eddie, who were a lot of the laugh inspiration in the original one. You know, Beverly and the other characters weren't so much the comic relief in that regard, and they really weren't that here either. They played it fairly straight, and all the actors did a great job, and the people they got to do as the kids was great too. But again, we had I unfortunately can't remember the actor's name, but him and Bill Hader, I mean, they just stole the show, in my opinion. They did such a great job. And James McAvoy was, of course, they were all good to great. I mean, it was just it was great watching these casts come together and make this movie. But I loved the characters. I loved seeing how they all changed as adults. But then when they came back to the town, they all started kind of reverting back to their childlike essences in a way, you know. The one guy kind of became insecure, you know, the heavier set guy. And you had the one guy who started getting, you know, more about germs and stuff again. And you just had the stuttering come back. And, you know, it was just like they were kind of... You know, they'd forgotten about this. They've all had their lives changed. They're going forward, and now they're back, and they're remembering what happened, and it, you know, it was just like, wow. Yeah, that was pretty cool. I liked that. I thought they sold that well. They went through this experience where they have to sort of recall things they might have forgotten. Now, I've heard a couple people say they didn't like this because you should have seen these moments, I guess, in the original, because, you know, we watched the movie and what they experienced as kids. And I get that, but at the same time, you know, obviously movies don't show everything of every person in every life and you know, everything in a life. And two, this did play pretty heavy into the plot line of this one. So, of course, you know, they don't want us rewatching a bunch of stuff. And they had us have a few scenes where, you know, they showed us things from the first one. But in this, you know, there was things that, memories that almost they had repressed. And I almost felt like the audience was a character of the film because we didn't remember some of the stuff that happened in Derry because, you know, you forget these things when you leave Derry. I don't know. I just thought that was kind of almost a fourth wall breaking element to the film in a way. Probably not supposed to be, but I just kind of interpreted it that way. Like, oh, they don't remember things and they're remembering memories. I'm now seeing that I don't remember that. Am I remembering their memories now too? You know, just a weird little thing that I picked up on for that. But, I mean, I really liked that aspect of the film because in the original, you know, they had to come together to defeat this thing. And they had to do that in this one, but at the same time, they had to go their own separate ways for a little while. And, of course, Pennywise, Bill Skarsgård does such a great job as the clown. Again, freaky, well into his character. You know, for a movie series that probably, the clown is probably in the two movies, a total of 20, 30 minutes, if that, and he still sells his scenes and is memorable for that. I mean, that's job well done, in my opinion. Now, the other thing, too, that I found fascinating about this chapter is, like, you know, you kind of saw some different things in the first chapter, but this one really seemed heavy on a lot of stuff, creatures and ways he was trying to go against the adults, and you got to see these things a bit more, and they just showed them more. It felt like there was definitely more of that going on, and just, like, you know, all hold, stop, just going forward. And I really like that element of the movie as well. And then, of course, you get the culmination of things happening at the end. And again, I really enjoyed that. I liked how they played with the past trauma with some of these characters during that element. And like I said, I could go on and on about this movie and why I loved it, but I mean, I think I pretty much hit it on the head there. I know that this is a kind of, everything is divisive, but I've really heard that It Chapter 2 is really kind of dividing audiences in a way. Some people have loved it, some people have hated it for various reasons, and I don't know, I've read some of these reasons now, and I just, that's not the experience I took away from it. Not to say that's wrong. For anybody who did, but I wasn't bored. I was entertained the entire time. I jumped a few times. I thought the atmosphere was creepy at times. I thought the humor was funny. I liked the emotional story stuff in it. It was some really heart-pulling moments in the movie. And, I don't know, I don't really have any, like, major complaints thinking about it. I mean, there's little things you can always critique and whatever, but as a second part and a continuation, I love the franchise. I know that, you know, this is the end of that story, but they have talked about potentially doing more in the series as prequels or something of that nature, and there is so much they could do with the creature, to give more backstory or show more things happening, because this thing was around for eons. So, yeah, it was just a movie I loved. I enjoyed some of the throwbacks to the original of this. Loved the there's a Stephen King cameo. Thought that was great, brilliant. And it's like even as dark as it was at times, it felt like a great companion piece to the first one. So that's just my thoughts on it. I'm sure many folks feel disappointed or just different, but yeah, that's me talking about It Chapter 2. What'd you think of the movie? You can tell me down below in the comments. We can have a discussion. We can keep it kosher. We can keep it, you know, just right, you know. No arguing, man. This is just entertainment. It's just for fun. That's why we watch and play games, right? Entertainment. So until the next video, I'm out of here. Because down here, we all float.